He was peacefully asleep. He was thinking about how he would finally have his first good night's sleep in months, when he finally drifted into the deep sleep that ends all thought and activity. Not even 3 minutes later, he awoke to a loud slamming sound. He saw the doors to his balcony open, but he was sure that he'd locked them. He went outside to the balcony to see what had happened. Do I really have to go back to sleep? It's such a nice night. No clouds, full moon. What the hell? He saw it. A shadow. Nothing to cast the shadow in the moonlight. Just the shadow. He blinked and the shadow was gone. Huh? He turned to admire the moon again. And then he felt a hand upon his back. He felt himself hit the ground. He awoke in the sanatorium bed. No one was in the sanatorium. Ugh, how did I get here? This place is abandoned. It was true. Stay Strong Sanatorium hadn't been in use since 1932. Windows were smashed, the light bulbs were flickering, and mostly just dead. He turned. Looking back, he didn't know why he did. To see a floating syringe full of glowing red liquid? It flew toward him. Before he even thought about it, he jumped out of the way. The syringe zipped past him and stuck into the wall. And he ran. After running for hours, he found the door. And when he turned to find the key, he saw the shadow following him. He didn't have time to unlock the door. He jumped through the glass, covering himself in shards. He felt himself being ready to bleed to death. He ran to the first building he saw. The music center, where the Philharmonic and other bands met and practiced. He slammed the door behind him. And he suddenly heard piano music. He instantly recognized the song. It was Scarborough Fair. He followed the music into a small classroom. The piano's keys moved, but there was no one at the piano. He eventually just accepted that the piano was playing itself and began to sing along, as there was no one to insult his singing, which he was very self-conscious about. Suddenly the piano stopped. He saw a piece of chalk float up and write on the chalkboard. Such a beautiful song to be the last one you ever hear. He screamed at the top of his lungs and smashed through the window. He realized instantly the time was midnight and the moon was very, very bright. But he left the sanatorium at daybreak not 10 minutes ago. He realized that he was in a tall cornfield, far away from the music center. How am I here? He began to feel extreme fatigue, and he knew he was bleeding to death. He tried to catch his breath, but his lungs didn't seem to be working. He heard a high, raspy voice command him. Look into my eyes. I want to see you die. Right after, he felt the shadow's telekinesis begin to crush his brain. The shadow revealed his true non-invisible form, a sight of true terror. As the shadow reveals himself only 3 seconds before you die, you see it. He tried to look up at the moon full and bright. It was something beautiful for the last sight he ever sees. But the shadow had put him into a state of hypnotism. He couldn't move at all. Thus, he died in pain, staring at a sight so horrifying, no one can even begin to describe the fear felt in seeing it. And he died. As for you, if you find that doors to your house suddenly open, no matter how beautiful the night is, close the doors, go to sleep, or the shadow will find you. Stay strong.